to start with a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, dear Jesus, we come before you now. Thank you for using me to speak your word. Thank you for guiding me thus far and granting your grace. Let your Holy Spirit take control of me and let him speak, not me. You know the needs of the people who are listening to these words. I submit myself to you so that you can use me to speak your message, Lord. For the power and the glory is yours. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Who does not know the story of Samson and Delilah? Everybody seems to know this. It's a tragic story of love, defeat, tragedy and deceit. As a child, I went to Catholic school. We had friars like monks as teachers. They really scared me. They scared me away from church for 40 years. But one of the stories they told me was the story of Samson. He was a guy who was a rebel. He drew his hair really long. He was really strong. And he was a bit stupid. I liked him. He told a woman who was obviously related to the enemy that his hair was his strength. But as a twist in the tale, right at the end, he killed all his enemies. This story, as it was told by these friars, it sounded a lot like a fairy tale. What did I learn from that story? Nothing much, except that it was cool to grow my hair long. And to be really strong. Well, I wasn't really strong, but I did grow my hair really long because this was a hippie time. In the early 1970s, I should have brought a photograph.
Oh,
I got my hair down to here. Yeah.
Share on Facebook.
Unfortunately, it did not make me any stronger. Those friars at my school, they missed the point because they didn't understand my Bible. Many years later, I read the Bible myself and learned that this is not a fairy tale. There are at least two very strong lessons that we will learn from this story. First, I have a few questions for you to see what you know about Samson. What was the source of Samson's strength? From God. Very good. Many people say it was his hair. Does anybody know what Samson means? The real Hebrew pronunciation is Shimshon. And it means the son of light. Or little son. Does anybody know what Delilah means? Have you ever heard the expression, it's, they were different as day and night? Well, Delilah means darkness. And the place of Samson's birth was Beth Shemesh. So Shemesh means sun. Beth means home, so home of the sun. We read Numbers a moment ago, and we talked about a Nazarite.
Nazarite.
Yes, I put the terms on the board there because a Nazarene and a Nazarite are very different things. We heard in Numbers that a Nazarite was not supposed to cut his hair. So that's the connection why Samson was not supposed to cut his hair. He was a Nazarite. Nazarite, not Nazarene, but Nazarite, comes from the word Nazir. Which means consecrated to God. Well, Nazarene is an inhabitant of Nazareth. And it's derived from the word Hebrew for branch. Nisa. So a Nazarite vow was somebody who dedicated himself or herself to God. Now there was three men in the Bible who were Nazarites from birth.